What if the monster wasn't hiding in the dark, but flowing through your blood? What if death wasn't instant, but a slow, invisible stalker, destroying you piece by piece, year after year, until your own body became the perfect host for the horrors inside you? This is not fiction. This is AIDS. And once it takes hold, survival becomes a nightmare race against time. AIDS doesn't start with a scream. It starts quietly. A cough. A fever that won't go away. A night where you wake drenched in sweat, heart pounding, with no idea that a predator is inside you. AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, emerges from one of the deadliest viruses known to humanity, HIV. Unlike rabies or Ebola that kill fast, HIV is patient. It sneaks into your blood, infects the very cells that defend you, the CD4 T cells, your body's soldiers, and one by one, it slaughters them. Imagine an army base invaded by an enemy that wears the same uniform as your soldiers. That's HIV. It hides, it multiplies, it destroys, until your defenses collapse. And that's when AIDS takes over. The real horror of AIDS is not the virus itself, it's what it lets in. With your immune system gone, the gates of your body swing wide open. Diseases that most people fight off with ease, like pneumonia, tuberculosis, or even the common flu, suddenly become assassins. Mouths rot from fungal infections. Lungs fill with fluid. Wounds never heal. Cancers that most people rarely see suddenly bloom like black flowers across the skin. The body doesn't just weaken. It becomes a playground for diseases waiting to feast. Here's the chilling part. AIDS rarely kills quickly. Instead, it lingers. It eats away at your life in slow motion. A person can look healthy one year and the next become unrecognizable. Bones jutting out of thin skin, eyes sunken, bodies wasting away in hospital beds. This slow decline has a name, HIV wasting syndrome. Victims lose not just weight, but their identity. Friends stop recognizing them. Families whisper about curses, and the infected are often left alone, abandoned by fear or by shame. And yet the virus doesn't stop. It waits silently until the last defense is gone. Where did AIDS come from? The horror begins in Central Africa, mid-20th century. Scientists believe HIV first crossed over from primates to humans when blood from chimpanzees infected with a similar virus entered human wounds during hunting. But once inside us, it evolved into something far deadlier. By the late 20th century, it had become a global plague. Entire hospitals filled with skeletal patients, families buried their children, their siblings, their parents. In some villages, every coffin was for someone who died of AIDS. It wasn't just a disease, it was a terror that spread faster than understanding. Perhaps the scariest part of AIDS is how personal it is. Unlike rabies or Ebola, it doesn't come from a wild animal bite. It spreads through human connection, through intimacy, through the desire to feel close to someone, to love someone. That's why AIDS carried such a heavy stigma. It wasn't just a disease, it was a mark. People judged, isolated, and abandoned those infected, turning victims into monsters in the eyes of society. But inside, they were the same people, just dying slowly. Here is the truth that makes AIDS one of the scariest diseases in history. There is still no cure. Yes, medicine today can keep HIV under control. Antiretroviral therapy can stop the virus from multiplying, can extend life for decades, can allow people to live almost normal lives. But stop the medication for even a few weeks and the virus comes roaring back, stronger than ever. AIDS is not gone, it is waiting. So next time you think monsters are only in the dark, remember, the deadliest ones don't stalk you in alleys. They live inside the body. They wait, invisible, patient, feeding on your strength. And when they finally show themselves, it's already too late. This was AIDS, a true medical horror.